Hi, this is Farooq Hashmi from thinkingneuron.com. In this video, I'll help you understand what is a t-test and when do we use it. So let's get started. So a t-test is one of the hypothesis tests which are used very frequently. It is one of the hypothesis tests. And what do we use this hypothesis test for? So we use this test to check whether the mean value of a sample, is statistically similar to the mean value of population or not. So we kind of guess or we kind of estimate whether the mean of population or the assumption which we make is valid or not based on a given sample. Like consider this scenario, like you have a gumball factory and it is producing gums. So a lot of gums are produced every day, and this is one batch or this one jar contains a particular lot of gum, and there is an ideal standard that these gums must be of some diameter. So if you take any random gum, then the diameter of that should be 25 mm. And if it is more than that, then there is a trouble. Your machinery is not working perfectly and it is not producing the correct gum. So this jar can be seen as the population. And this randomly drawn sample is the sample given to check whether they are being produced with the expected quality of 25 mm diameter or not. So here we say the ideal mean value should be 25 mm. So this is my H0, or I assume that the mean of population is 25 mm. The diameter should be 25 mm. So this is my H0. This should happen, and I'm expecting that this should be present. So with this expectation, if I take all the gums from this population, if I take all the gums present inside this jar, then the average should come ideally to be 25 mm. So I'm just checking that instead of measuring each and every gum present in this jar, I've taken a sample of let's say 20 gums. And then I start measuring for this sample the diameters. So for 20 gums, I can do it because it's a small sample. So the values which I observe look like this, like 25.12, 25.22, 24.09, 24.99, so on and so forth. And let us say for the sake of explanation that this mean value of sample came out to be 24.3 mm. Okay, some gums are slightly bigger, some gums are slightly smaller as compared to the ideal value, but the average comes out to be like this. Now statistically speaking, I need to check whether this 24.3 mm really belongs to this population or not. So to test that, I am going to use t-test, and t-test is based out of t-distribution. Right, so a t-statistic is computed. To compute t-statistic, I need to also understand that the standard deviation of this sample is what. So for the sake of explanation, let me just assume the standard deviation came out to be, for this came out to be 0.1, just for the sake of explanation. Now I can compute a t-statistic. So how do we compute t-statistic? T-statistic is computed as mean of sample minus mean of population divided by the standard deviation of sample by square root of number of values. So this is the calculation, or this is the formula which gives me the t value for this example. Like I have 20 gums, so I can replace these values. So some mean of sample came out to be 24.3 minus mean of population is 25. I'm assuming the mean of population should be 25 mm, and the standard deviation came out to be 0.1, and I'm dividing it by the root of 20. So this expression gives me a t value. And this t value, if you evaluate, comes out to be -31.30. Now, this is a t value which I need to check in the t distribution, in the probability density curve of t. So the probability density curve of t values look like this. It looks like this. So it looks like normal distribution only with a slightly elongated curve at the ends. So some values are negative and some values are positive. And it is centered around zero. So the highest probability of t, this in x-axis it is t, and the y-axis what you have is probability. So this is the probability density curve of t values. The most frequent t value is around zero. So you expect that the t value which you are getting, if it is around zero, then the probability of getting such a value is very high. And if you are getting a t value which is very far away from zero, either on the negative side or on the positive side, then the probability of getting such a value will be very low. So in this example, we are getting -31.30, which will come out somewhere over here. So it's very far away from zero, and that is why the probability of getting such a p value will be very low. So if the probability or the p value per se comes small, then this occurrence is very unlikely. So I will reject my null hypothesis that this sample belongs to this population. It is very unlikely that this sample really belongs to this population, or there is some trouble in the samples. The sizes are not of the expectation. The sizes are not of the ideal expectation, and that is why this sample is bad. And I can conclude that there is some trouble in the overall machinery. So based on the sample, I am getting an information about the overall population. Like, I assumed it to be like 25, but based on the sample which I am observing, it doesn't seem to be true. It's very far away from the population, and this t value will be equal to zero when the mean of sample is nearly equal to the mean of population. So the numerator will turn out to be near to zero. And in that scenario, your t value will be centered around zero. And if the mean of sample is far away from the mean of population, then the numerator will increase and the t value will also increase. And that's how you will get a low probability of getting such an extreme t value. So based on this probability density curve, we find out the probability, and this probability is returned by the t test as the p value. And based on the p value, we either accept or reject our hypothesis. Okay, so I hope this helps you to understand what is a t test, and you'll be able to explain this in an interview with confidence. So all the best for that.